flux context is amazing. Let's understand how to use it, starting from the smallest 4 gigabytes model up to the 24 gigabytes model, all of which can be found here on Hugging Face. The examples here showcase how it removes objects flawlessly, such as this dog. Writing text inside a pattern, stuffed toys, or skateboarding looks good. Inside files and versions, this is the original model with a file size of around 24 gigabytes. If you have a graphics card with 24 gigabytes of memory or more, then you can download this and save it inside models, then the diffusion underscore models folder. In this notepad, I have links to the file I will be using in this video. So if you do not have a 24 gigabyte card, then you can look at this FP8 model. These links will be shared in the video's description. Here is an FP8 model with a file size of 12 gigabytes suitable for most users. If this is too large for your graphics card, then you have an option to look further at the GGUF models. Starting from Q2 till Q8, the models are good in comparison to their sizes. The smallest model is of 4 gigabyte in size. Let's look at the workflow, and it is simple. These three nodes take the files we will be downloading. These three nodes deal with the image, bringing it into the workflow. And this keeps the image size in check and further gives the image to the encoder. So the image added here can be used in a latent space. Here we can have a preview of the image we are giving to the K-sampler. These three are the condition nodes. The image we are generating has certain conditions. It's not a random image. Our prompt here is a condition. It also takes the image with a prompt as a condition for the K-sampler. When we upload an image and ask to do something with a given image, then it becomes a condition. And within that condition, the new image has to be generated. So everything goes to the K-sampler, and then the result is converted from the latent space to the pixel space in this decoder, and then it is sent to the save image node. These are the installed nodes in my Comfy UI. I will be adding the GGUF node to test the GGUF models ahead in this video. For now, I need to have the file required in place to run the workflow. I will download the FP8 model. As this is a SafeTensor file, I will save it inside the diffusion model folder. Next is the clip loader, which takes two files. Inside files and versions, these are the text encoders. You can have any one of them. I prefer the smaller one due to memory limitations. Download and save the file into models, and then into the text encoder folder. I also need the clip.l file, which was present here. Save it inside the clip folder or in the text encoder folder. The last file is the VAE used to encode and decode data like images around the latent space. Save it inside the models and then the VAE folder. Now I can use the context model to manipulate images. After the download, I will quickly refresh by pressing the letter R and check whether all the files are found by Comfy UI. There are two nodes for taking images in this workflow. I will bypass one, or I can say disable one. Let's try working with one image first. My prompt will be the woman with a mustache, and click Run to generate. The preview is visible in this node, which is the condition. And within this condition, I had asked for a mustache. If you have a 12 gigabyte card, then your system RAM will be utilized more than what you see here. This model should work on a 12 gigabyte card after using some system RAM. It took around 2 minutes to generate the result, and it looks fine. This is not super realistic, but the AI was able to find the face and position the mustache where it is supposed to be. I then asked for a beard, and the second image took 97 seconds. The image looks fine as per the surroundings and other elements of the image. Overall, it is good. I think this is good because the other way this could have been done is by using in painting. And in painting changes the face to some degree. My prompt here was a woman standing on a cliff in a wedding dress. The generation time now was consistent, around 90 seconds, and this is the result. The woman got the wedding dress, but with the armor. I should have said something like, her outfit is a wedding dress. I wrote the prompt, the woman on a cliff wearing a wedding, and somehow forgot to type the dress. And it worked with the correct prompt. What do you think? Does the face look similar to the original character? I can say yes, this model works like magic with the right prompt. I generated an image of a vintage car, and I will use it here to make some changes to it. My prompt was, change the car color to red. I queued the workflow to process, the preview is here, and after 90 seconds, I got this nice paint job on the car. Well, the car image was generated using the SDXL model, so it has some flaws. The same was carried forward by the context model. I copied the image and thought of fixing it using the context model. Now I had no idea how to fix it. My prompt was to remove all the cars from the background. I queued the workflow, and I knew this won't work. And it did not. I was able to correct it by the prompt, remove the two cars from the background. I should have mentioned this earlier. You do not have to copy-paste the image from the result always. You can click the refresh button here to get the newly generated image. The car looks good on the beach. The light reflected from the sand affects the shiny red color of the car, which is great. Now let's try two images. My prompt was, place both the characters sitting on a bench in a park. Cue the workflow to process. In the preview, it's visible. Both images have been attached together side by side. And the same is sent to the case sampler as a canvas. Also, do note that the size of the canvas is no more around 1024 pixels. After 98 seconds, I got the result, and both of them are sitting on a bench. I will make a copy of these image nodes and try to process four images at a time. With the help of the image stitch node, I have brought four images into the workflow. There is a different node that takes multiple images, but I need to install a different custom node for that. I want to keep this video as simple as I can, so I have not shown other nodes here. My prompt will be, place all the characters on the beach playing volleyball. I clicked run to process the workflow, but the preview image looks wrong. All four characters are stitched, but the lengthy image was cropped. The image generated here includes only two characters, which is as per the preview image. I will bypass this node and try running the workflow again. Now all four characters are stitched. The iteration time got increased from 4 seconds to 27 seconds due to the lengthy image. I am sure the result will be bad because the model is trained to generate an image with a size of around 1024 pixels. The length of the canvas I give to the K-sampler is around 3000 pixels. As expected, it took 550 seconds, and the image looks bad. The rabbit got wings. I tried again, and the result was bad. Later, it worked and gave me three characters. What I did was I removed the latent connection from here to the K-sampler and gave an empty latent image with a different pixel size. It was a hit or miss kind of situation. I will try it later on a different workflow. I am sure it will work. This model is quite promising. Let's have a quick look at the GGUF models. I have downloaded these two models, Q2 and Q6, from Hugging Face. The link will be shared in the description. Download and keep it inside the UNet folder. Also, I have added a custom node by name Comfy UI GGUF. Install the nightly version of this node. After installing the node, you should get an option to restart. Restart the Comfy UI interface. And in the workflow, double-click and type GGUF. Select this UNet loader. Connect the node to the K-sampler, and then select the downloaded GGUF model. I will select the Q2 model. In this example, I will be using only one image. And for that, I can use the image node directly. I will upload an image of a person working on his laptop and write a prompt for a clay art. The term used to specify this art is claymation. I will also remove the empty latent image and give the latent image of the person I have uploaded. The AI needs to work on the same image I have uploaded. The iteration time was 6 seconds, which is more than the 12 gigabyte model. After 139 seconds, I got the result. The image had no effect. This happens sometimes. I don't know about other users. Restarting the comfy UI and loading the model again fixes the problem. I queued the workflow again, and I got the result. It has a slight effect of claymation. Increasing the guidance scale should work. Let me check the difference between this Q2 model and the 12GB FP8 model. I will change the connection and run the workflow. The execution time was 109 seconds, and the difference is quite noticeable. I tried using the Q6 GGUF model as well. The Q6 and Q8 model gives good results, as per the comments I read by other users. And the result looks good. The Q6 models generated a decent result. I will use the same image and try something else. Click the refresh button to get the new image here. My prompt was character plucking flowers, and cue the workflow. After 140 seconds, I got the result. And the character was supposed to pluck flowers, but I did not specify where he should be doing so. I later specified that the character is plucking flowers in the garden, and I got the image. The workflow I am using can be found here in the top left of the comfy UI. Click Browse Template. Then go to Flux, and these are the two workflows. I will click on this basic workflow, and it gets loaded. These are the notes you can refer to for typing prompts and a few other details. On the right, these are the nodes I have used to generate images in this video. I had opened and kept it in such a way that the connections were visible. Upload the image here. You can upload two images by enabling the second node. Write the prompt here. The preview will be visible here, and this is the Save Image node. On top, this is where you need to select the files I showed you to download. The model, clip, and text encoder, and here is the VAE. For DGUF models, make sure you have the custom node I showed you earlier in this video. Search the UNet loader and select the model. Make a connection with a K-sampler, and you are ready to generate. I think that is it. You can enable the second image node here, like this. The other workflow is similar. You can download this FP16 text encoder if you have a 24GB card. So, here in the second workflow, you can see these are the two nodes to bring the images into the workflow. This is where you write the prompt, and below is the result generated based on the uploaded image and prompt. The generated image is shown, but again taken further to process based on the second prompt. And below is the node for the second result. You can copy this and extend the workflow further to make some comic stuff. The process is similar to what we see here. It was just a workflow with multiple generations. I will try a different workflow for multiple images. I will post here if I find something new. Let me know if the video was helpful.